Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This little piece of plastic will be the main focus of this video. And this is a Maxton Design V1 front splitter. So, part is not expensive, part just came for 125 euro plus shipping from Poland. It's another 100 or so euro. And I have some few interesting things I didn't know until the part arrived. So let's just take a look before we get to how to install this thing. So first of all, this is not my first choice of splitter. I actually wanted a Harman style splitter. I'm gonna cut in the picture here to show you how that would have looked like. Problem that I couldn't find this splitter is because I want ABS. This part is going to be the lowest point on the car and all the way on the front lip. So you will scratch it, you will get stuck somewhere eventually, you will have damage on there. I mean, just look at my front bumper. The lowest part here does have some scratches. It did take some beating, so a splitter here is usually not a smart idea. So the problem with the Harman style splitter was there was only one in ABS. There are plenty of carbon fiber and fiberglass, but those are prone to splinter, and I'm just not up for that. You want the most durable material, it is ABS. It scratches, it bends, but it doesn't shatter to like a million pieces. Was only one split available. By the time this part was supposed to arrive, I got a message from the seller saying, oh, we don't have it anymore. So then I just continued searching and I found Maxton Design. They make a bunch of different splitters from V1 to V5. Just a little bit different. I went with the most kind of understated. I don't really want an aggressive look. I just want the lip to come a little bit lower and more forward. And I think this one will do that. So you see it's like three little bars in the center and then it attaches to the flaps on the outside. It's one piece. There are no holes or anything pre-drilled. It's nothing. Right now there's a protective film on there. If you wonder where the scratches are, that'll be the first to take off. Then I will try to remove that sticker here because it doesn't go with my color theme. And then I will pre-drill holes. It came with some fasteners, like some 16. So I decided to go with like two in each of these. One in the front, one in the back. And then I have like five for each ring left over. So probably will go like one, two, somewhere here, three, four, five, and in between and on the back I will just go with some double-sided tape. But if you look closely, you also see that you have some fasteners here on the bumper already that hold your underbody paneling in place. So that's going to be colliding, and I'm still trying to figure out how I get these to still work out in conjunction with this splitter. However, the biggest point that got me by surprise, this nice piece, just cut it without scratching it. Yes. So probably the reason why I never found any pictures from the underside of this piece, there is none, is literally just one form pressed piece of plastic, and that is it, that's all. I've never seen anything like that. It is weird to the max. But I guess you just get what you pay for, maybe? But man, that is tedious. Interesting, weird little splitter. The first test fitting looked promising, or at least not so bad that I say get it out of here. So I will install this and see how it looks like. So I already encountered the first problem. I showed you where I was planning to drill holes and attach it, and now the LED kicks in. So you see like these flash bars in the bumper. And that limits extremely where I can actually place the screws, because you see the bumper is literally right up to it. This is on the sides. And the same in the front. You see also the crash bar there. It limits extremely where I can place the screws and where not. Bummer. So instead of placing the screws where I wanted to, like here and here and here and here, I have to go back and just place them somewhere here, 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 and I don't even know if I can fit one here. Because about this far in, here is where the crash parts are.
that I cannot place any screws because of space restraints. And that's the same over here, so I have to put a screw in the back here. But you want to have it in the front, because that's when you need the strongest connection, because the wind's going to attack here and pull it down here. Having a screw in the back is not ideal at all, and I will have to just add some double-sided tape all around and hope that that's going to do the trick. So unfortunately I'm losing sunlight, so I gotta be a little quick on here. What I did over there's a splitter, I somewhat test fitted it, just used a jack to center it in the middle, hold it there, aligned it a little bit as good as I could by myself, and then I taped it on the sides. Then I just drilled the holes, you can see now, there's one, there's one. And on the side you see a bunch. It's not ideal at all, but like mentioned before, I can't go further to the front because of the structure underneath. So these are the structural bolts I use, and I drilled some like this one here and two more down there, because those are the screws you need to hold the other body panel on there. I used isopropyl alcohol to clean this off. This is clean. I will install some 3M double-sided tape on the edge here, give it as much strength as I can, and the ones for the center, I will install those on here on the splitter itself. Now first I take off the sticker here, start from here. After that I will clean the surface also. Now I see it in all its beauty. Still, I don't like the sticker here. It's like a gel. Oh, shit. Did it come off? It's going to be a problem. There you go. Just have to take the residue off. Gone. Okay. So here it is. This is the lip installed. The car is not on the ground yet. Fitment on this side is pretty much perfect. On the other side, it's a little bit sticking out to my taste. So you can collect debris in here, but hey. The worst part, however, is the front here, like you see, because the angle is just too big, you have nothing to kind of really get in there. I try to put in some underbody screws, the short ones, and one longer over here, but that's really touching the carry on the inside, and these don't really grip anything, so I have to think what I'm going to do about that, if and how I add some more strength to that. As you can see, passing through here. But let's get it on the ground and see what it looks like. Okay, and there it is, finished result. If you pay close attention, you can see that this side is a little bit further out than the other side. But overall, my only concern are just these in the front. Because there's a little gap. And because there is a crash bar behind here, it's impossible to get a screw in here. But on the other hand, the side wings, they are all nice and smooth and flat.
You are able to see the color difference in it. My car is in jet black. This bumper is just gloss black, just like a standard black. And even if it were the same tone, even if it were jet black, which is close enough, then you would still see the color difference because this is aged paint, this is brand new paint. This is gonna be way darker than the original paint. I like it actually, beside the weird beginning, but it's just a decent little extension to the front, mostly on the wings, that's what I wanted. A little more aggressive, not too aggressive. And of course it pulls the entire lip further down. Let me know in the comments what you think about it, about this Maxton V1. If you like it, if you were chosen a different one, or if you have another idea how to secure these three little bumps a little better than it is right now, I'd appreciate that. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.